Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject heat mass transfer. And this is lecture number 15 on radiation heat transfer, module 5. The topic is gas radiation. So in the previous lecture, we discussed the theoretical part of the gas radiation. How to calculate radiation heat transfer between the gas in an enclosure and the wall. And in this lecture, we solve few problems on the gas radiation. And at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the gas radiation. That is the learning outcome. And this gas radiation problem is very much applicable for gas turbine combustion chamber and in the IC engine combustion chamber. So in the IC engine combustion chamber, you have the hot gases and the heat is transferred between the hot gases and the piston, reciprocating piston. Closer is steam turbine, gas turbine combustion chamber, where the flame is available. So the flame, from the flame there is radiation, the hot gas are radiating, and many components inside the combustion chamber of the gas turbine or the steam turbine, they are absorbing heat by radiation. So the gas radiation calculation is applicable for all the combustion chambers. So we take the example number 1 from the anonymity question paper. A cylindrical furnace whose height and diameter are equal to 5 meter contains combustion gases at 1200 Kelvin. The total pressure is 2 atmosphere. The composition of the combustion gases is determined by volumetric analysis. It is to be 80% by nitrogen, 8% hydrogen H2O, 7% O2 oxygen, and 5% CO2. So determine the effective emissivity of the combustion gases. And write down the given data. So the diameter is equal to, length equal to 5 meter. Gas temperature is 1200 Kelvin. Total pressure is 2 atmosphere. Percentage of nitrogen is 80%. Percentage of water vapor is 8%. Percentage of oxygen is 7% and percentage of CO2 is 5%. And we have to calculate the partial pressure of H2O and the CO2. And for the gas radiation problem, we have the properties, we have the data only for water vapor and the CO2. So during the combustion, the major constituents are CO2 and water vapor. So any fuel is a hydrocarbon. The hydrogen in the fuel combined with the oxygen, react with the oxygen that produce H2O. The carbon in the fuel react with the oxygen that produce CO2. These two are the major constituent of the combustion gases. And we have the data only for the combustion gases. There are other gases available in the combustion gases, nitrogen, like nitrogen and oxygen. So we do not have data for it. So we just skip it. So we calculate the partial pressure of H2O, water vapor, and CO2. So from the given data, so we are given percentage of CO2, which is 5%. So 0.05 into 2, total pressure is, atmospheric pressure is 2 atmosphere. So this is 0.1 atmosphere. The partial pressure of water vapor, pH2O equal to yH2O into P total, which is 0.08 into 2 equal to 0.16 atmosphere. Now we have to calculate the mean beam length of the cylindrical furnace. So from the table, page number 111 in the heat and mass transfer data book, the cylinder, for a cylinder, height equal diameter, beam length L equal to 0.6 times of the diameter, so which is 0.6 into 5, which is 3 meter. Now the emissivity of CO2 we have to take from this graph. So this graph is available in the heat and mass transfer data book. X-axis temperature, Y-axis epsilon CO2. And the lines for PCO2 into L. So partial pressure of CO2 into beam length. So we calculate partial pressure of CO2 into beam length, which is 0.1 into 3 equal to 0.3 atmosphere. And the gas temperature is 1200 Kelvin. So we take horizontal line, we draw a vertical line at 1200 Kelvin. It will meet here at 0.3 and the emissivity of CO2 equal to 0.16. So we have to calculate PCO2 into L, which is 0.3 atmosphere, and TG equal to 1200. For these two information, you draw a vertical line, and here you can read the emissivity of CO2. And the correction factor for CO2, the total pressure is, x-axis is total pressure, because the total pressure is 2 atmosphere. And this line for PCO2 in DL, what we calculated earlier, 0.3 meter. Now for 2 atmosphere, you draw the vertical line, it will meet here for 0.3 atmosphere. So the value is 1.1. So correction factor for CO2 equal to, CCO2 equal to 1.1. Then we take the emissivity of H2O. So this is the graph for emissivity of H2O. X-axis is the gas temperature. Y-axis is the emissivity of H2O and the line for pH2O into L. Beam length into, this is what the beam length into partial pressure of water vapor. Now we calculate pH2O into L. So 0.16 into 3 equal to 0.48 atmosphere, Tg equal to 1200 Kelvin. So now for gas temperature 1200 Kelvin, we draw one vertical line and it will meet here 0.48. So we have 0.46 and 0.48 and read the value, emissivity of H2O equal to 0.23. Then the correction factor for H2O, so the x-axis value pH2O into PT divided by 2, that is partial pressure of H2O plus PT divided by 2, calculate partial pressure of H2O is 0.16. Total pressure is 2 atmosphere divided by 2 equal to 1.08 atmosphere. And already we have the pH2O into beam length equal to 0.48 atmosphere. So this 1.08, you draw on vertical line, it will meet here for 0.48. So this is 0.35 and next line is 0.76. And somewhere here we have 0.48, this is 1.4. So the correction factor for H2O equal to 1.4. Then the emissivity correction factor delta epsilon for mutual absorption when H2O and CO2 present in the mixer. So when you have two gases, so we have to take the value of delta epsilon. The x-axis value is pH2O divided by pH2O plus PCO2. The partial pressure of water vapor is 0.16 divided by 0.16 plus 0.1, which is 0.6. And the lines for PCO2 into L plus pH2O into L. So already we have 0.3 plus 0.48 equal to 0.78. Now for the x-axis value 0.6 and lines for 0.78, temperature is 1200 Kelvin. So draw one vertical line for 0.6 and then draw the horizontal line, you will get 0.05. So the delta epsilon equal to 0.05. And we calculate the emissivity of the combustion gases. So this equation is also available in the heat and mass transfer data book. Epsilon G equal to epsilon CO2 CCO2 plus epsilon H2O CH2O minus delta epsilon equal to, substituting all the numerical values, 0.16 into 1.1 plus 0.23 into 1.4 minus 0.05 equal to 0.448. Then we write the answer to the problem. The emissivity of the combustion gases is 0.448. We take the example number 2. A gas turbine combustion chamber is 0.35 meter in diameter and the walls are maintained at temperature 500 degrees Celsius. The product of combustion are at 1000 degrees Celsius and the pressure is 1 atmosphere and contains 12% CO2 and 10% water vapor, H2O vapor by volume. Determine the net radiant heat transfer per unit area, unit surface area. So the given data. So for the cylindrical combustion chamber, we are given the diameter equal to 0.35 meter. Gas temperature is 1000 degrees Celsius, which is 1273 Kelvin. Wall temperature is 500 degrees Celsius, which is 773 Kelvin. Total pressure is 1 atmosphere. Water vapor percentage is 10% and the CO2 percentage is 12%. We calculate the partial pressure of the water vapor and the carbon dioxide. So PCO2 equal to YCO2 into P total equal to 0.12 into 1 equal to 0.12 atmosphere. Partial pressure of H2O, PH2O equal to YH2O into P total, which is 0.1 into 1 atmosphere equal to 0.1 atmosphere. So the mean beam length for the cylindrical furnace from the page number 111, heat and mass transfer data book, infinite cylinder radiating to walls, L equal to 0.9 times of the diameter, which is 0.9 into 0.35 equal to 0.315 meter. So the mean beam length equal to 0.315 meter. Now we take the emissivity of CO2 from the graph. So this graph is available here, data book. So we calculate the x-axis value. X-axis value is gas temperature 1273 Kelvin, and the line for PCO2 into L. So partial pressure of water vapor is 0.1, partial pressure of CO2 is 0.12 into 0.315 equal to 0.0378. Now for the gas temperature, you draw one vertical line. So for 1273, you draw the vertical line. It is meeting here at the 0.0738. So the emissivity of CO2 equal to 0.075. Then we take the correction factor. So the total pressure is 1 atmosphere. So 1 atmosphere, it is meeting here. So the correction factor is going to be 1. So the correction factor equal to 1 for the CO2. So CCO2 equal to 1. The emissivity of H2O water vapor. So again, you take the parameter. So pH2O into L equal to 0.0315 meter. So here we have the pH2O into L, and the gas temperature is 1273. You draw one vertical line for the gas temperature 1273. So this is meeting here 0.0315, and draw the horizontal line. So the epsilon H2O equal to 0.045. Then the correction factor from the graph, next graph. So correction factor, so x-axis pH2O into PT divided by 2, which is 0.1 plus 1 divided by 2 equal to 0.55 atmosphere, and pH2O into L equal to, already we calculated, so 0.0315 atmosphere. Now for 55, you draw on vertical line, and it is meeting here. So the correction factor for H2O, CH2O equal to 1.08. Then we take the delta epsilon for mutual absorption of H2O and CO2 vapor present in the mixer. So the x-axis value pH2O divided by pH2O plus PCO2, which is 0.1 divided by 0.1 plus 0.12 equal to 0.4545. And the sum of the two partial pressure. So PCO2 L plus pH2O L equal to 0.0693. So the temperature is 1273 Kelvin. We take the last graph 1200 Kelvin. And the value is 0.004, delta epsilon equal to 0.004. Now we calculate the emissivity of the combustion gases. So the equation is available in the heat mass transfer data book. Epsilon G equal to epsilon CO2 plus CCO into CCO2 plus epsilon H2O CH2O minus delta epsilon. Substitute all the values. Epsilon G equal to 0.075 into 1 plus 0.045 into 1.08. minus 0.004 equal to 0.1186. Then we have to take the absorptivity of the CO2. So the same graph we have to use, emissivity of CO2, the same graph we have to use. But now we have to take TW, wall temperature, 773 Kelvin. Instead of gas temperature, we have to take 773 wall temperature. And here we have to calculate the value PCO2 L into TW by TG. So that is what the equation that you have to calculate. So now look at here. So we calculate 0.023 atmosphere. So 773 divided by 1273, 0.023 atmosphere. Now you draw a vertical line for 0.773, and it is meeting here 0.023223. Then you draw the horizontal line. So the alpha CO2 equal to 0.073. So absorptivity of CO2 is 0.073, and the correction factor for CO2, the same graph once again we have to use, but now the value is PT equal to 1 atmosphere. For 1 atmosphere, the CCO2 equal to 1. Then you have to calculate absorptivity of H2O, the same graph what we used for emissivity. So epsilon H2O is there, so the same reading for alpha H2O. But the value is PH2O L into TW by TG, and the TG, instead of TG, we have to take the TW value. TW equal to 773 Kelvin. So this is not TG, it is TW equal to 773 Kelvin. Now you draw a vertical line for 773, it is meeting here 0.019 atmosphere, and the value is 0.055. So the correction factor for H2O. So the x-axis value pH2O plus PT divided by 2, so 0.55 atmosphere, you draw the vertical line, and the correction factor is 1.08. Then the mutual absorption, So the same graph, again 0.04 to now, and the value is 0.001. So we have to refer the same graph for absorptivity also, but we have to take it for wall temperature and the correction in the beam length into TCO2. So we have to multiply by TW by TG. Now we calculate the absorptivity of the combustion gases using the equation. So equation is also available in the Heaton Mass Transfer data book. So alpha G equal to alpha CO2 CCO2 into TG by TW to the power 0.65 plus alpha H2O CH2O into TG by TW to the power 0.45 minus delta alpha. So substituting all the numerical values, 0.073 into 1 into 1273 divided by 773 to the power 0.65 plus 0.055 into 1.08 into 1273 divided by 773 to the power 0.45 minus 0.001 is equal to 0.1742. It means absorptivity of the gaseous mixture is 0.1742. Then radiant heat exchange between the gases and the wall. So this equation again is also available per unit area. So Q by A equal to sigma into epsilon G Tg to the power 4 minus alpha G Tw to the power 4. So substitute the numerical values. 5.67 10 power minus 8 sigma 5.67 10 power minus 8 into 0.1186 into 1273 to the power 4 minus 0.1742 into 773 to the power 4. So calculating the amount of heat flux heat transfer per unit area is 14.13 kilowatts per meter square. So the answer to the problem, radiant heat exchange is 14.13 kilowatts per meter square. So when you want to calculate the heat exchange, the absorptivity of the gaseous mixture, we have to use the same graph but for different parameter. So that is very important that you note down and you solve one problem on your own so that you will get the familiarity of using the graph. And we take example number 3, determine emissivity of the gaseous mixture consisting of N2, H2O and CO2 at a temperature of 800 Kelvin. The gas mixer is in the sphere with a diameter of 0.4 meter and the partial pressure of nitrogen is 1 atmosphere, partial pressure of H2O is 0.4 atmosphere and partial pressure of CO2 is 0.6 atmosphere. And the given data, the gas temperature is 800 Kelvin. Diameter of the sphere is 0.4 meter, diameter of the chamber is 0.4 meter, partial pressure of H2O 0.4 times atmosphere, partial pressure of CO2 0.6 times atmosphere, partial pressure of nitrogen 1 atmosphere and the total pressure is 2 atmosphere. And the mean beam length of the sphere, so page number 111, Heaton Mass Transfer data book, L equal to 0.6 times the diameter, so 0.6 into 0.4 equal to 0.24, beam length is 0.24 meter. And the emissivity of CO2, so we calculate PCO2 into L, 0.6 into 0.24 equal to 0.144, and the gas temperature is 800 Kelvin. Now for gas temperature, you draw the vertical line and it will meet there, and you draw the horizontal line, the emissivity of CO2 equal to 0.14. So then we calculate the correction factor for CO2, the total pressure is 2 atmosphere and PCO2 into L equal to 0.6 into 0.24 equal to 0.144. Now you draw the vertical line for 2 atmosphere and you will get the, it will meet here at 0.144, you draw the horizontal line and CCO2 equal to 1.2. And the emissivity of H2O, pH2 into L equal to 0.4 into 0.24, which is 0.096, and the gas temperature is 800 Kelvin. For 800 Kelvin, you draw the vertical line, it will meet on the 0.096, then you draw the horizontal line, so the epsilon H2O equal to 0.16. Then we calculate the correction factor for H2O. So the pH2O PT divided by 2 equal to 0.4 plus 2 divided by 2 equal to 1.2 atmosphere, and the pH2O is pH2O into L equal to 0.4 into 0.24 equal to 0.096. Now you draw an arithmetical line for 1.2 atmosphere and the correction factor is 1.6. Then we take the mutual absorption curve. So the emissivity correction factor for mutual absorption x-axis value pH2O divided by PCO2 into pH2O, which is 0.4 divided by 0.4 plus 0.6 equal to 0.4, and the sum of the value, so this 0.096 plus 0.144 equal to 0.21. The temperature is 800 Kelvin, so we draw one vertical line for 0.4 and for 0.21, so the value is 0.012. So delta epsilon equal to 0.012. Now, the emissivity of the combustion gases, you take the equation from the data book, epsilon G equal to epsilon CO2 CCO2 plus epsilon H2O CH2O minus delta epsilon. Substituting the numerical values, epsilon G equal to 0.14 into 1.2, 0.16 into 1.6 minus 0.012 equal to 0.412. So, the answer to the problem, the emissivity of the combustion gases is 0.412. We take example number 4, a long cylindrical combustor 40 cm in diameter contains gases at 1200 degrees Celsius consisting of 0.75 atmosphere nitrogen and 0.25 atmosphere CO2. What is the net heat radiated to the wall if the walls are at 400 degrees Celsius? Now the given data, diameter is 0.4 meter. Gas temperature is 1200 degrees Celsius, which is 1473 Kelvin. Wall temperature is 400 degrees Celsius, which is 673 Kelvin. Partial pressure of N2 is 0.75 atmosphere. Partial pressure of CO2 equal to 0.25 atmosphere. And the total pressure is 1 atmosphere. And here water vapor is not given. So, we have only CO2. And nitrogen is not, the data for nitrogen is not available. And it is inert for the combustion process. So, we have to take the properties only for CO2. We have to take the emissivity absorptivity only for CO2. And the mean beam length for the cylindrical furnace from the page number 111 heat and mass transfer data book, infinite cylinder. So, L equal to 0.9 times of D. So, 0.9 into 0.4 equal to 0.36 meter. So, mean beam length equal to 0.36 meter. And the emissivity of CO2. So, from this graph, x-axis the temperature of 1743 and the PCO2 into L 0.25 into 0.36 equal to 0.09 atmosphere. So, you draw the vertical line for 1473 Kelvin and it is meeting here 0.09 atmosphere and the emissivity of CO2 is 0.095. And the correction factor, so total pressure is 1 atmosphere, so the correction factor equal to 1. So, 1 atmosphere you meet here. So, the value equal to 1. And the absorptivity of CO2, now the PCO2 into L into TW by TG, and you have to calculate, this is 0.04 atmosphere, and the TW equal to 673, you draw one vertical line for 673, and it will meet here 0.04, and draw the horizontal line. So, epsilon CO2 equal to 0.088. Then C correction factor is also 1 for 1 atmosphere, total pressure 1 atmosphere. Then emissivity of the gaseous mixer, epsilon G equal to epsilon CO2 CCO2 equal to 0.095 into 1 equal to 0.095. And absorptivity of the gaseous mixer, so alpha G equal to alpha CO2 CCO2 into TG by TW to the power 0.65. This 0.08 into 1 into 1473 divided by 673 to the power 0.65 equal to 0.133. So, radiant heat exchange Q equal to capital Q, heat transfer per unit area equal to sigma into epsilon G Tg to the power 4 minus alpha G Tw to the power 4. So, Stefan Boltzmann constant 5.67 10 power minus 8 into 0.095 into 1473 to the power 4. Minus 0.133 into 673 to the power 4 equal to 23.81 kilowatts per meter square. So, the answer to the problem is 23.81 kilowatts per meter square. And example number 5, a furnace of total surface area 30 meter square and volume 10 meter cube is maintained at a temperature of 1000 degrees Celsius over its entire volume. The total pressure of the combustion gases is 2 atmosphere. The partial pressure of the water vapor is 0.1 atmosphere and CO2, partial pressure of CO2 is 0.3 atmosphere. Calculate the emissivity of the gaseous mixture. And the area, given data, the area of the combustor, combustion chamber is 30 meter square, volume is 10 meter cube, gas temperature is 1000 degrees Celsius, which is equal to 1273 Kelvin, total pressure is 2 atmosphere, partial pressure of water vapor is 0.1 atmosphere, and partial pressure of CO2 equal to 0.3 atmosphere. And the mean beam length, so the formula L equal to 3.4 into volume by area. You can refer to the data book, so page number 111, in the same table, all the data are available. So 3.4 into 10 by 30 equal to 1.13 meter. Now for emissivity of CO2, we calculate PCO2 into L, so 0.3 into 1.13. 0.3 into 1.13 equal to 0.339 atmosphere, and TG equal to 1273 Kelvin. And you draw the vertical line for 1273 Kelvin, and you will get 0.16. Epsilon CO2 equal to 0.16. Then correction factor for CO2, the total pressure is 2 atmosphere. So PCO2 L equal to 0.339. So you will get 1.1. CCO2 equal to 1.1. So 2 atmosphere drawn vertical line, you will get the line value here 1.1. And emissivity of H2O, so pH2O into L, which is 0.1 into 1.13, which is 0.113 atmosphere, and TG equal to 1273 Kelvin. So draw the vertical line for 1273, so it will meet here 0.1 at 1.113. So the value is 0.12. Epsilon CO2, epsilon H2O equal to 0.12. Then correction factor for H2O, so the x-axis value pH2O into PT divided by 2, so 0.1 plus 2 divided by 2 equal to 1.05 atmosphere, and this pH2O into L equal to 0.113, so draw the vertical line for 1.05, and the correction factor is 1.5. Then we take the mutual absorption, emissivity correction factor for mutual absorption of H2O into CO2 vapor, so pH2O by pH2O plus PCO2 equal to 0.25. And with the sum of the value PCO2 L plus PH2O into L equal to 0.452. Now you draw one vertical line for 0.25 and the value is 0.038. Now the emissivity of the combustion gases. So epsilon G equal to epsilon CO2 CCO2 plus epsilon H2O CH2O minus delta epsilon equal to 0.16 into 1.1. Plus 0.12 into 1.5 minus 0.038 equal to 0.318. Now the answer to the problem, emissivity of the combustion gases is 0.318. And these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. So you can refer to it for additional problems and the theory on the gas radiation. And I have published a book on the subject. You can refer to it for more detailed information, and if you have any queries, you can write to me. I will sincerely answer. So I thank you. So if you have any comments on the video, you can type there, so that it will help me to improve the presentation in the future. Thank you very much.